there anything more satisfying than a good old-fashioned explosion? In our last episode, we looked at how to create moving projectiles in Scratch. But as every die-hard gamer knows, it's not really combat until stuff starts blowing up. Explosions in video games are usually triggered when your target sprite collides with a projectile. To pull this off, Scratch needs your enemy's code to constantly be checking for collisions with your projectile. We've accomplished that here by putting an if statement inside of a forever loop. It really makes no difference whether you code your projectiles to detect enemies or code your enemies to detect projectiles. Things get a little tricky though in games where you have cloned projectiles shooting cloned enemies. In this example, my laser collides with an enemy clone and both of them receive a command to delete this clone. When I fire, my laser disappears, but my enemy is undamaged. To understand why, we need to slow things down and look at how Scratch processes information. As fast as computers are, they can only execute one command at a time. When my laser hits an enemy, it follows the instructions in its code and deletes itself. After processing that command, it's the enemy sprite's turn to run its next instruction. It checks to see if a laser is touching, but there's no laser because it's already been deleted. A simple fix for this dilemma is to make the projectile pause for the tiniest moment before deleting itself, just long enough to be detected by the enemy. The smallest delay you can add to Scratch is 0 seconds. Zero sounds like no delay at all, but in reality Scratch still pauses here and jumps to the next sprite without getting a chance to delete itself. Now both our sprites are deleting themselves and it's time to add our explosion. If you have an artistic side, you can design your own explosion graphic, but you can find all kinds of explosion graphics on the web. For the best impact, find an explosion that has an invisible checkerboard background and one that has a built-in animation. Try clicking the Tools menu in Google Images to filter your search so you're only seeing animated GIFs. A lot of new Scratchers aren't aware that animated GIF files will import into Scratch as multiple costumes. To import your explosion, just click on the enemy sprite and open up the image editor. Click on the blue cat icon to upload new costumes and select your animated explosion. We've now added 24 frames of explosion costumes underneath our original spaceship sprite. Let's go back to our collision detection script and add 24 next costume commands before we delete our sprite. You might need to resize your explosion to make it fit the proportions of your ship. You might also want to add a tiny delay between costume changes to slow down the explosion. Now add an explosion sound effect and... boom! You're the scourge of the battlefield.
I feel the liftoff. The clock has started. Roger.